Well, ladies and gentlemen, what's going on? Welcome back to New Super Mario Bros. Wii. Last time we, of course, did World 7, finished it all 100%, marvelous, super duper, all done, fine and dandy. Today, first half of World 8, and this level, should be the only one that really causes us grief. As you can see, we're in a volcano land. Of course, you know, most Mario levels or games end like this. Destroyed level world thing. And we're also running away from a giant cloud of smog. Like I said, as long as you can get past this level, the rest of the episode should be a doddle. Should be so easy. Whoop, took that. Oh, well, I'm dead. I didn't expect to land on the beetle there. the only reason why it's slightly difficult, and I would consider it difficult, is because of the smoke cloud and those pillars of lava that shoot up from the big lava lake at the bottom. Because you have to wait for them to get out of the... Or you have to wait for the lava pillars to descend before you can continue on. Oops. And of course you've also got this big smoggy cloud behind you. So it does add a bit of a time constraint. What? I did not shake. Shake Sonora. That time I did. We've got to wait for this pillar to come down before we can jump over it, and meanwhile there's a small cloud behind us catching up, so that's the only thing which might cause an issue. So first, Starcoin is up here. Whoops. You just wait for the mushroom to tilt that way, and then we jit. Whoa, I didn't realise I got that. Beetlejuice, it's nearly Halloween. Actually, what day is this episode going up? It's gone Halloween! You know, one of the films which I used to watch a lot when it was Halloween was Beetlejuice, because it's quite an old film, and my parents made me watch it. So, there you go. Okay, second star coin coming up. We need this power brick here. Grab it and run with it, and drop it here, because the star coin will fall down. Marvelous! Okay, so continuing on, I want to get over here before that pillar comes up. That one which I just threw the beetle into. It's okay, they're fireproof. So, they're lava-proof, right? So just basically run through as much as you can before... Oh dear, this could be bad. Before the smog comes. No. Well, I died. I'm going to cut back to this bait. Okay, I think I died here. Yeah, I died here. Okay, so let's take our time. But it's really difficult because the boulders, basically. Just because of the boulders. Trying to remember where the third... Oh yeah, the third star coin is right at the end, which is where we are right now. So to get the third star coin, I guess you could destroy that brick like that, or you could jump over using the mushroom. But I guess you can destroy the brick like that. Crud. I really shouldn't have took my time there, but use the spring to jump up. There will be boulders that destroy these bricks here, so it makes it impossible to all jump up. I guess, though, you could still jump up. Why am I taking my time? There's a big smog cloud, but there you go. that's the third star coin, so both pipes sort of bring you out here, but it's cool. Woohoo! And one up, so we get to 99 lives once again. Marvellous! So I shouldn't have died two times, was it? I think I died twice. I shouldn't have done that. I should have been better than that, but I wasn't. Anyway, let's continue on. Saving the Princess Peach in the final world. Almost there. We've only got two more levels to do before the castle, or the fortress, sorry, not the castle. Again, I tend to call it tower. I always mention that. But yeah, we've got sort of the same thing at the beginning here, but it's actually an underground level, so... the title which I... Oh! Title of a previous video I said no more caves. It was wrong. Well, there was no more caves for that world. It was World 7. Because there weren't any more caves. Because we were in the clouds, and if there was a cave in the cloud, then that would be worrying. But this level is relatively easy and very quick to do. Whoops! Are you gonna be one? No, you're not. Just make sure you avoid the big spiky balls. Well, they're not big spiky balls. You'll see the big spiky balls, but these are the little ones. The star coins are all relatively easy. I mean, look at this one, right up here. They're quite well hidden, though, so you need to know where to look for them. Checkpoint already, look at that. There is a secret exit on this level as well. We'll actually get these red coins because we need a power-up. Well, we don't need a power-up, but... I haven't seen one for a while, so let's just get one. Oh, ice flower. Marvellous. Continuing on. There's going to be an ice flower here, isn't there? Yeah, there is. Right. Boink. So, second star coin is down under the pipe of Goombas. Boop, there we go. Just go away, Goombas, please. Thank you. So just make sure you... just, yeah, do that. I won't be getting the secret exit this time, because we can only get one exit to go. I want to get all the star coins instead. So there should be a big ball. Yeah, here comes big ball. Just jump past it. I didn't jump past it, I jumped on it. And the star coin, or the third star coin, is just under here. Boop. Right there. Right next to the exit. Oh, hi, big ball. Didn't expect you to be there. Just right next to the exit pipe, just underneath it. I mean, look at how easy that level was. For a World 8 level. Okay, and then... yaha, woohoo. And jump onto the... almost top of the flagpole. So like I said, there is a secret exit in this level. I will jump to where it is, and I will see you guys in un momento. Okay, so the secret exit is by the rolling balls. It's underneath us at the moment. If we just jump down here, it is to the left. You have to time it quite well to get in there. But yeah, there's a pipe, and it just leads to an alternative exit, which leads to a hidden level. But we do have to sort of jump along, and this bit is really tedious. There's a power brick here. You don't actually need it. It's not for anything. It's just for the Goombas, really, because there is a Goomba pipe. And they will go ping. Well, they don't exactly go ping. They're really slow, but you know what I mean. Just jump on top and head up this pipe. Up the pipe. You know, it's weird. Mario's meant to be a plumber, and so is Luigi. But you never see them fixing pipes. They're always just going through them. Oh, and I got it. Nice. Sweet. So yeah, maybe one day we'll actually have a game where Mario is actually a plumber and we'll fix game, or we'll fix pipes with it. Or with him, sorry, not it. I wonder what that game would be called. But yeah, there we go. Secret level unlocked. We'll see the little pillars pop up out of the lava ocean, and a secret level there. I think basically you can do that level and it will take you directly to the end level, which you will see next episode. But yes, for the purposes of doing things in numerical order, we will do number 3 next, not 7, because I think that's 7. So this level, again, really easy. All you got to do is take your time, which you know I'm excellent at. We've got these... we've got these... well, the lava waves here. You can actually do the one-up trick with this, with all the Koopas. If you do it well, or time it well enough. But yeah, just make sure you... get off the chandeliers in time. I mean, I can do this level ridiculously easy. watch me die! But, ooh, that was close. All you gotta do is take your time, make sure the lava doesn't touch you. Which is easier than it sounds, really. So with this second star coin, you just have to go to the right-hand side when there's a hole in the lava and jump down and follow the lava back along. Oh, hello, that was a... That was some sort of message. Sorry, my tablet just went boop boop at me. Okay, so we got some fire chomps here. Again, just carry on going across. The last star coin is here. Again, just wait for the gap in the thing and jump in. No, there we go, 3 star coins, sorted. All you have to do is jump across the lava. Oh dear, don't die, don't die, Dale. There we go. Ooh, safe as houses. There we go, pop in here, and look at that. World 3, or, well, World 8 3, done! Of course, we're going to have a little jump thing to do here. Oh, wow, I got it without even trying. Well, of course I try. I always try, but you know what I mean. I got it when the chandelier thing was really low. What's that even? Is that a chandelier? I don't even know. That's not a chandelier. It doesn't have lights. A chandelier has lights. So, completing the level, the bridge will appear. Hello, bridge. How are you today? You look very lovely. And, we're going to have to do the little mushroom one-up token thing. Is it not a one-up token thing? It's a mushroom token thing. Which is super easy. Just... whoops. I was going to say just dodge all the fire things. There we go. Got them all. Boop. Sorted. Done. Boom. 3 mushrooms. Easy peasy. Lemon and pie. And now we get to do the tower. The tower, the tower, the tower. A really, really easy tower. Really does remind me of the sort of first Mario games, you know, the first Super Mario Brothers with all the fire pillars, because that's what we're going, or fire bars, sorry, because that's what we're going to see today, just lots of fire bars. Other than that, this level is really easy. Oh, and some pillary things like this, which are might crush you. So again, it's another case of taking your time, doing things slowly. Unlike me, who likes to rush everything. So this star coin can be a bit tricky. You might have to wait for the bar to be in the right place at the right time. But I mean, look at that, fairly simple. If you don't want to lose your power up, it's really easy to do. Boop, another power up right there. Sorted. Doesn't matter if you go left or right. Actually, is there something to the right? It looks like there's something to the right there in that wall. I don't actually know if there is or not. Oh, there is. There's a hidden door. It doesn't have anything in it, but there's a hidden door. Well, it doesn't have anything. Oh, it's got a special power up block thing. What do we get? Extra life. Fantastic. I really needed you. Right. Okay. So, let's go back and continue on. I would actually advise going up the left-hand side. It just makes it a lot easier. Yeah, I'm gonna go up the left-hand side because it's easy to jump with the fire, but it's not easy to jump sort of into it. Whoops, that makes any sense. You'll see what I mean. Like with this one, it's easy to jump behind the fire bar and stay here, whereas with the other side, you would have to jump sort of into the fire bar, which isn't going to be too easy. So we're gonna have these interlocking bricks, which I just completely failed at jumping on that. We need to use these to climb up. Very simple, just don't get crushed. Stand on the platforms which don't move. And I don't think there's anything up here. Nope, nothing up there, no shortcut. So continue, continue. Big fire bar here, just jump over it, it's fine. Again, nothing there which we need to concern ourselves with. Now we need to wait for this thing to get out of the way. Get out of the way! Thank you for doing as I ask. And jump. That didn't work. That didn't work. That didn't work. Just dodged it. So the two other star coins are going to be right next to each other. This bit's interesting. The interlocking, what they called bricks, I guess. Well, they are bricks. Just jump where you see coins, and you'll be safe. If you've already taken the coins, then oh dear. Okay, that'll do. If you've already taken the coins, then you're stuffed, really, unless you've got a really good memory. So don't get crushed. Oh, actually, no. There's a star coin in this door. So you saw where I jumped up. There. So with the big interlocking thing just underneath the checkpoint. Don't go up the other side, or you can't get it. So this star coin is really easy to get. It looks a bit daunting, but it isn't. Just go to the right-hand side. There's a power up here, if you need it. Wait for the fire bar to come up there. Oops. Oops. Oops, let's try again. Wait for the fire bar to go up, jump on the platform, and back down again. Easy peasy, super duper easy. And the second star, or the third and final star coin, you saw it. I advise getting it before the checkpoint so that if you do die, you don't have to get it again. I mean, I know it's right there, but still, every little helps. Now, when you're saving Princess Peach, you need this spare time. I wonder if I can actually... Shortcut, there we go. Okay. So, boss door, boss door. I think this is a power up here. So get it if you need it. The other side is just a coin, as you saw. There's nothing else there, I don't believe. So we shall go into the door and face Kamek. Hello, Kamek! Where are you? There you are. Hello, you're on your broom. Hi! You gonna sprinkle magicness on no one? Oh, you're gonna sprinkle magicness on someone. So yes, he will sprinkle his magic all over the stage. And the stage will slowly move left. Really tricky. Oh, except he does actually make the stage disappear. Oh, well, no, he turns them into enemies by the looks of things. He will sort of teleport around the place, just wait until he gets sort of out of range, and then stomp on him. Oh, dear. Oh, dear. Well, I'm going to cut back to here. Well, that never happens. That wasn't supposed to happen. I wasn't meant to die, of course. I wasn't meant to die. Literally, I didn't realize the midway flag was about 10 seconds away from the boss door. I could have just carried on talking over that, but oh well. So here, this will be a demonstration on how to properly do it, rather than dying. Oh dear. So yeah, it is a bit frustrating. Oh, here she goes. Or it goes. Is it he or she? I can't remember. So just wait until he reappears somewhere far away, because that is when he will, or it will, fire off something magical and... just carry on waiting. So that's kind of far away, but he didn't reappear. Oh, why do you keep doing it when you're right next to something? So obviously if he's directly underneath a brick, it's going to be quite tricky to Oh, can I? Yes. Obviously, if he's directly underneath a brick, it's going to be tricky to stomp on his head. So I guess you could fireball him if you can. Or if you stand close to him, he will teleport away. And he's, of course, not dead for good, because he's going to run away to the end of the world. Well, quite literally the end of the world, if it's all covered in lava and breaking up into pieces. Into the airship. So yes, that's where we're heading next time, guys. That's the first half of World 8 done. Thank you all very much for watching. I will, of course, see you in the next episode when I wonder what we're going to be doing. Are we going to do the last half of World 8? Of course we are. Help you? No. Thanks again, and I will save and see you later. Bye-bye!